late night version of Muscle Car Madness. We're working in the dark tonight. All right. So kind of a interesting day here. Going to be an interesting night. Apparently, we're going to put the doors on. And D said we're going to put the fenders on. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen or not. But, you know, maybe. So come on in the garage. Late night version of Muscle Car Madness Garage. So let me fill you in on what D's doing. So here's, now if you all remember, that's fiberglass under there. You remember from last time? That's all fiberglass, filling that in. And there's his line going all the way down. Now that's filler, of course. He's just blocking it off. You're not even gonna be able to tell it. This whole thing now has been tacked in, as you can see, all the way down, and this is going to be finished tonight. Hopefully we'll be able to prime this up tonight. That over there is done. This right here, done. All this, done. I'm going to take the seat out. I got some sanding on a part. Show you what. I've got to sand this. This is a fender brace. I was going to buy a new one. When I looked at the prices of a brand new one, reproduction, $165 for this thing, I said, you know what? I'll clean up the other one. It was cracked, so D put some fiberglass on it. I cleaned it up. I'm going to paint it. Put it back on there. Yep. Over here, we got in some, these are door hinge brackets. They go on the inside of the pillars there, up and down. Right there. Trunk is done. String straight. Ready to paint. Got to put on that wing later on. And the rest of it is ready to go. Yep. Looking real good. All right. So that's it. So I'm going to get to work now and I'll check in with you in a little bit. Yes, sir. 351 running like a top. I hadn't cranked it in 3 days. Pop right over. Literally, I turned the key, bam, pop right over. So then, therefore, I was concerned about that 10 and a half on the gauge. Now, we had a master mechanic come in today, a friend of D's. He said, let him tell you. Well, what did you find, sir?
Well, actually, I saw the car is running perfectly, running fine. And I worked his gauge. And on the gauge, when I advanced the cover, I thought it up. I saw the gauge start adding like more pounds to the fuse when it should be going less. It should be about 7.5 to 7 to 5. It should, when you throttle it, it should go down to, right, I guess 5 to 4. But when I gave it gas, it went down to 15. When I speeded the carburetor up, it went down to 15. So I'm thinking, my problem is, the gauge is not working properly, or I'd rather try another gauge first before I make my assumption that it get too much fuel.
Look at the thing here. It's on 12 now, and the car ain't even running. Should it not be at zero now?
Well, it should be all the way down, like the fuel gonna do. But you know, we're bleeding the fuel from the line right now. So it probably just holding the fuel pressure in the line. It probably what they're doing now, holding the fuel pressure in the line, 'cause you're gonna bleed the fuel line.
Okay. So what we're gonna do is, that's a cheap gauge. We, you know, that fuel rail was. Holly had one and it didn't fit unbelievably just right. So this was a fuel rail that has, you know, it works, but I believe that gauge is apparently a piece of junk. So you know what? We're not going to do anything other than to replace that gauge. That's what we're going to do. When this thing is running like a top, and I ain't going to muck around with it. All right. So thank goodness, right? That just a little leaf on my mind. Now with that stage, you know, we got ourselves a real showman here. We got ourselves a, you know, I don't want to call the man a prima donna. Now, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to say that he is a prince of sandpaper. I'm not going to say that. But we all know he is. All right, D, tell us.
Well, touching up on a few little things, and after that, we're going to get some paint on him.
He's a perfectionist. Like, he can't let it go. See?
Well, if you see it, you got to fix it. You can't just lay the paint on there and you ain't got the little nicks and necks out of there. You got to overlook it before you lay that paint on it, because the paint is like a mirror reflection of what's on the body, you know?
All right. So our goal maybe, is to get this thing painted today, maybe. Because we're going to do the doors, we're going to do the fenders. They're all coming out, and guess what else we're going to do? We're going to put that paint booth up today. Huh? Paint booth's going up today. Here it is. That paint booth is going up. And it's going right here. Y'all remember? Perfect space to do all this. So today is sunny in Birmingham. Beautiful weather. It's on. All right. So here we go, y'all. Let's go to the paint booth. You see what he's doing? Look what he's doing. Cutting open my paint booth. I have owned this paint booth for 2 years. And now this joker comes into my garage less than a month. What's he doing? Cutting open my paint booth. The paint booth is going up today. It's going up. At Musclecar Madness Garage. All right, here it comes. Check it out, y'all. Woo! This booth fits perfectly in this slot. I had measured it. I had measured it a while ago, and I knew what kind of space I had to work with. I believe I got it right. Power lines, didn't even touch the power lines. The Mach 1 is not quite this long, but we're just doing the backside of the Mach 1, you remember? So this is the filter. Right here, I'm stepping on the plywood right here. So that's a filter. These two are just screens. Maybe they're filters as well. Filter over there. This is a area, I guess, for entering in. Yep. You enter in here. No doubt, the little door there. This is where the air is coming in. Right here. We're going to go ahead and spray the fenders laying right there, here, doors. They're gonna be done here today. It's hot here in Birmingham, so that'll be no problem. Let them cook outside for a little while. And then we might just put the Mach 1 in here. Today may be the day. I don't know, maybe. I tell you right now, though, I could not be more satisfied with this product. How about you, D? You okay with this?
Oh yeah, I'm more than okay with it.
Okay. All right, so now we're going to put the fenders in there, get it prepped up, get this thing rolling. Yep. All right, we got both fans pumping. That one is to the frame. This one is in the interior. This area here, area where everything is mixed. The air then pumps in here. Out through these filters here, it continues to flow through here, force out on those green things. Yeah, and that's how it is. That's how it's going to work. So this little paint booth is awesome. I'll tell you that right now. And they got all kinds of sizes. But this is the size that I had to have for what I was doing. The hooks up top, if you wanted that, anything you need. All right, so Dee's making his final prep here. Next step, white fenders. Okay, I'm out of here. I can feel that air coming out of here. Oh yeah. I can feel that air moving out when I do that. Yep, because that's that vent. All right, y'all, let's do a quick update. These are mirrors. They now have been totally primered. Look good. This is the one that's that thing you adjust from the inside. Okay, let's check on D. Check him out. Oh yeah. Look at the fumes. I don't know if you can see the fumes coming out of that paint, but I'll leave it to it. Next on my list are two back windows. Right here, got an original, I don't know what that was. What's it say? Electronically protected. Yeah, right. And over here as well. Now this one has that extension down. This one does not, but I painted the support bracket is right over here. Right, so I've already painted that with a black flat or a flat black matte paint. It's around here somewhere. I'm gonna do the same thing. But I believe on this car, those things may already be in place, as you can see. Well, maybe, yeah, I think they're in there already. Those things, I think. Doesn't matter, because I got them anyway. So I'm gonna go and clean these up and paint them with a flat black. I believe it's right here. No, it's right here. Yeah, this is a black paint. Guide, coat, black. Yep. And so that's what I am going to do on these two right here. I have gone ahead and ordered this, that rubber stripping right there, and reordered. All right, so let me get cracking on that. All right, y'all, next step done. Thing nice and clean. Windows nice and clean, or clean as they gonna get. Yeah, of course, all that will never be seen, but been painted with a Rust-Oleum, and it'll never be rusted again, that's for sure. Okay, as far as D is concerned, my paint, or my compressor there, he said called a wuss. It's a lightweight compressor. Call it a wuss. And so he's doing it real slow. So he's losing some time, as you can see. Now look. So the two fenders are done. One door is being done. And so, go right here, take a look. Yep. So, we're gonna have to let this thing run all night. Yeah. Gonna have to run all night. I can't, the boost gotta stay up all night long. Cause those things are gonna stay in there all night long. So then therefore, we're gonna pick it back up and get the car painted on Tuesday. Today is Sunday. And so that's what's gonna happen, apparently. Yeah, one more door, the trunk, and that's it. Just a small trim parts. Then the car will push it in there on Tuesday. And then that's it. There'll be no rain on Tuesday here in Birmingham. So anyway, that's it for now, y'all. Oh yeah, one last other thing. Here's the trunk. And then the hood. Here's the backside. I don't think I ever showed you guys the underside of that hood. This is it, a Ram Air hood. And it's got the holes, as you can see, for those things, but we're not going to use those. But as you can see, it's got a stamp, I think, of 96. So obviously this wasn't an original hood, but it is in really, really good shape. Not a speck of rust on it. We're going with a flat black on this hood. And I am not gonna go with those decals either. We're just gonna go flat black with it. So anyway, all right, y'all, that's it. Wow, what a day here at Muscle Car Madness Garage. She's just moving in light speed. It couldn't be more excited. We're getting to the end of the paint and body phase here. Now I'm starting to order trim, window moldings, drip rails, things like that. And then after that, we're gonna be doing the interior. I think I got the exhaust thing figured out. I'm gonna order a new gauge for the carburetor. And as far as the engine concerned, that's done. The clutch is something we still haven't done. All right, but everything else, we're moving in light speed. So anyway, I appreciate y'all stopping into the garage. I look forward to your comments now, that's for sure. Mark, Pedro, like hear what you say, JC. So be sure and subscribe, like, and then like I said, share and comment. I'll see you guys next time on Muscle Car Madness Garage. Happy Memorial Day. And appreciate all you veterans that served our great nation. Thank you.